Welcome to Programming with Qt Widgets. I'm Jesper Pedersen from QTopia. In today's episode, we'll look at how does the event system in Qt work. We've already seen that there is an event loop that runs around and picks events out of an event queue, but let's dive a bit more into details on that. Do you remember the very first class you saw in Qt? Well, in this video series, of course. Well, it was Qt application. What did you do to that Qt application besides instantiating it? You called exec on it. And if you started your debugger, any Qt application, if you go up, 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 you will end up in main on that line where you call exec, because that's where the event loop starts. And at that stage, the event loop runs around and processes events. But how do these events come in? Well, they come in from many different sources. So it might be the user moves the cursor around and he pressed the button somewhere. Then there would be a mouse button press event. It could be that he typed on his keyboard or he scrolled the mouse wheel. It could be that a timer timed off. It could be that data came in over a socket. Many places in Qt generate these events. They are being put into the event queue. So whenever Qt see, say, the user pressing a mouse button, when it sees that, it will say, okay, let me instantiate and a subclass of queue events, in this case here, a queue mouse press event or queue mouse event. And that event will then have member variables describing the event. So in the press, it likely tells you where was it pressed. In the key press, it will tell you what keys are being pressed down and so on. The event loop runs around, picks out one of these at a time, and when it sees one of those, it will say, okay, so who were you meant for? And yes, you got it right. It's for queue objects that it was meant for, because queue object is the topmost class of this hierarchy of event processing. And that queue object will then be sent the event. And the way that it's sent the event is that a method is called on queue objects, and that method is called event. If it's actually a queue widget, then there is a subclass of queue object, queue widget, that override the event method. And the processing will happen in the queue widget that knows about the widget specific events. And you can add to that yourself, and we'll see that somewhat later in this training where we'll create our own events. But for now, that's enough. So in the case of queue widget, there are many specific widget event, mouse press, mouse move, key press, key release, focus in, focus out, enter, leave, and so on and so on. And I'll actually show you the list of events shortly, and you'll notice there's lots and lots of events in there. So in queue widget, you could, if you wanted to act on specific events, you could override the event method of queue widget and then test whether the event that came in was a mouse press and then handle mouse press. If it was mouse release, then handle mouse release. And if it was a whatever, then handle that. And that method would very likely be very long. So for that purpose, the dear friends at Trolltech back in the days when they implemented this, they created that enormous switch for you inside of QWidget :: event. So they test for the type on the event. Is this a mouse press event? Then we will call upon, as you can see here, a virtual method called mouse press event. So you, instead of overriding event, you will override mouse press event, key press event, and so on. Some events, they play into a system where the event handler itself is accepting or rejecting, or rather ignoring events. And as an example of that is drag and drop. If you drag something onto your widget, then your widget will be getting a drag enter event. And at that stage, the widget will unpack the information that was dragged onto it and look at it. Oh, you're trying to drag a Microsoft Word document on me. I don't know what to do about that. So it will ignore it. Or, oh, it's a text file. Yes, I know how to handle that. You can drop that on me. And then it will say accept. And the drag and drop system will acknowledge that by changing the cursor. some events are propagated to their parent. And this is parent-child relationship we're talking about, not object Q widget, Q lineage. So it's not inheritance. It's that a Q, my gizmo is inside a, visually inside another area. And those events that are propagated up, well then, if I was creating some widget that had a small area that I wanted to paint in a specific way, but it didn't accept mouse events, then these mouse events would be propagated to the surrounding widget that then would handle them or propagate it further up. I'd like to show you two semi-real world examples of the event system going on in Qt. And let me start the first one for you here. If you notice up here, it says close event, and now it says close event with an asterisk. That was because after 3 seconds, I marked this window as dirty. And notice this cross up here. That's the one that this is all about. So when I press this cross, it will come up and ask me, really close the window, yes or no? And if I say no, it will not close it, despite that I press the cross. Yes, now the window is gone. And let's look at the application here. It's super simple application just to show just this one thing. So I have a close event here, and my close event is one of these event handlers that are overridden by, or that QWidget provides me to override. And it's called whenever the user presses that cross up there. And you can see that it brings with it a close event, and the close event obviously doesn't have much additional insight in it. But inside my application here, in the close event, first of all, you see I have a timer, 3 seconds, set window modified to true. That is what makes this asterisk appear. And the window title must have square bracket asterisk square bracket end for this to work, and then it will be put. So I could have the square bracket there or there or there. It's just an indication of where should that asterisk end up whenever the document is dirty. The rest is just layout. And here's my event handler. If window should close, then call accept, otherwise call ignore. And what window should close does is that, if first of all, let's just run again. If I close it here within the first 3 seconds, it's not dirty. And therefore, is window modified? Well, no, it's not. Then just return true. And then I will accept and the window is closed. Otherwise, I'll bring up this dialog here saying, really close the window, yes or no. And that's will return a Q standard or standard button from Q message box enum. And I will answer, I'll return whether I was yes or no. That was, and if it was yes, then this returns true and I close the window, or it returns false and I do not close the window. That is a very common use case that you have this concept of dirtiness, and it's super useful that you have this insight of the where is it? This set window modified, and the test is window modified. Let me be brutal honest. This is the first time I ever seen this flag myself. You have no idea how many places I have a bool m is dirty. I should go and clean that code up now, I guess. That's my sad face, because Black and White Jesper will soon tell you that that was the end of this module. But while you're waiting, go and have a look at this white paper on software craftsmanship. It tells a lot about how we do things in KDAP, and I'm sure that's the thing for you to learn. The second example I'd like to show you on event handling involves actually painting with the cursor on the screen. And for that, I need to have a small interlude here and tell you just a tiny little bit about painting in Qt. We'll get back to it in much more details later on. But what you basically do is that you paint using a class called QPainter. And on the QPainter class, there is a number of methods. There's drawLine, drawText, drawPixMap, and so on. But you're only allowed to draw on widgets in the virtual method that's called paintEvent. paintEvent is an overridden event handler like mousePress and so on. And it's something that Qt calls on you, but you can ask Qt to call that on you, and you do that by calling update. The details about why all of this I'll leave for later on. But for now, let's just see the application for the painting here. So I have an instance of a class called Scribbler, and let me just run the application here so that you can get an idea what it is we're talking about. Scribbler is 400 by 400 pixels. That's what you can see here. And now you know why I got into programming and not to be an artist, because this is the fullest extent of my drawing abilities. So not that good. Scribbler is a subclass of Qt Widget, so we call show on it. And let's see what the scribble area itself looks like. The scribble area is a subclass of Qt Widget, as I said. It's overriding three event handlers: mouse press, mouse move, and paint event. And let me just bring it up again. You can see when I press down the mouse and I move it around, it's drawing. When I release and move it around, it's not drawing. I press down and move around and it's drawing. Then there's paint event. And paint event is what will actually get the pixels on the screen. And when I'm moving around, I'm not getting those pixels on the screen. I'm purely putting them into an off-screen drawing, which is a Qt painter path. And here is what it looks like in the source code. I start out, let's go down to the mouse press event. Mouse press event, I am moving my drawing, I move to this position. So it's basically telling the off screen storing that I am starting at this position here. And then whenever I press down the mouse button and I move it around, my mouse move event will be called, and I'm drawing here. Still just only into my off-screen pix map. And then I'll call update. Update will make the pixels show up on the screen. And there I'm creating an instance of a Qt painter, and I'm setting the pen to be 3 pixels black, and I'll do my drawing. That is as simple as it can get, at least for the event handling inside of Qt. We listen to the events that we are interested in, and we are doing whatever we need to do whenever a mouse press comes in, a mouse release, and so on. And I did promise you that I would show you a list of all of the events. So let me show you it in two different places. Starting with the event description inside of Qt Widgets documentation. What you can see here, we have an action event, a change event, a close event, a mouse move, press, release, and double click. And we have paint event and resize event, and so on. Let me also take you to the source code of Qt Widget :: event. So I'm inside of Qt's own source code now, just to show you what's going on here. Switch the event pointer type. So any event has a type that is an enum that you can go and get that information. And you can just see if the event is platform surface, then do something. If it's mouse move, then take my event and cast it to a Qt mouse move event and call mouse move event, which is this virtual method. If it's a mouse button press, and so on and so on. Now, if that list wasn't impressive enough, and I didn't even scroll there on the Qt widgets event section, or those that it was overriding, that wasn't impressive enough. Let me take you to qcoreevent.h, which is where the enum for the events is. And that's what you're looking at here now. There is timer, that's the first event, mouse button press, mouse button release. And if I'm going to read all of these, then we better speed up the playback speed, because as you can see, there is a lot of different events that is going through the system. And not all of these events applies to every single platform even. So here we have max size change. That is when the QWA_Mac, I'm sure that has something to do with Macintosh, whenever that changes there. Or we have some if-def here, if-def gestures. So it's possible to compile out, if you are on Qt Embedded, to compile out certain features that you are not interested in. Let me just scroll on. And we finally made it down here to where there is user events. So if you want your own event, then you just create your event with an integer of that enum that is user+1, user+2, and so on. That's it for this episode of Programming with Qt Widget. It's actually also it for this module of the material. I'll have a short break here now for recording the next part, and the production team will need to do their work and so on. But in the follow-up part, we'll talk about widgets, and we'll especially talk about layout managers. But I hope that you at least got some good start here. And the cool thing about our trainings is that they are not just skirting on top of things. They are diving into detail. So even if you have a month of practical experience before you're watching the next thing, I promise you that there will be stuff to be learned in there for you too. Until next time, have a great summer, winter, or whenever this is released at your time or when you watch it. For me, it's summer. You might even be able to hear there's a thunderstorm coming over my city right now. But, well, that's time. It flies. Until next time, have a great time.